What an absolutely barren landscape. It is stunningly beautiful. Wow.
As you can see, there is nothing out here. You don't see any animals, you barely see a bird. That's just how it is in the winter. In the summer, there will be a lot of birds, there might be horses, there might be sheep, but in the winter, only the fox snooping around. But he is camouflaged, so it's difficult to see him. Although he would be in the area, it's very difficult to see him because he is white. And the only bird to see here when it is like this is what we call a rjúpa, and it's a ptarmigan. Same as with the ptarmigan, like the fox, they will like mate for each other. She gets white in the winter, brown in the summer, just like the fox. White in the winter and the brown in the summer. That's to say, this is the Arctic fox.
We've come about 6 kilometres inland to visit this lava field where there's lava caves, and it's freezing, -2.5. Wind chill takes that quite a bit further down, but I think this has to be one of the most beautiful, stunningly beautiful places I've ever been in my life. Not just for the vista and the views and the scenery, but for the experience of being here. You can see these lava fields, you see all the ripples where the lava's flowed through, and beautiful, beautiful place. Currently standing at over 1,000 feet up on the glacier. It's -6.5. Wind chill. And this incredible vehicle has got us up this high. So I can't do much focusing really. But absolutely stunning. Got the most incredible eerie blue glow. I don't know how much of this you're really picking up. The camera's not focusing particularly well, but it really doesn't do it justice. It's just a stunning view. Getting dark now, of course. There's only about four hours of daylight in Iceland in the winter. Actually, let's turn the camera around. Get my ugly mug on shot. So, there you have it. Best bits of Iceland so far. So, exceptionally cold, as you would expect. But I've got my two best hats for me, the Reymir's beanie. And the Buffy beanie. Ben and Lois Orford, so both hats have now been to Iceland. You know, well wrapped up, well looked after clothing wise, I'm not daft. Well prepared for the clothing side of things. But, well, first real day here and what an experience. I mean, driving around in this truck, the mountain taxi guys are just awesome. You can come to a place like this and do your own trip, but there's nothing like local knowledge. There's nothing like going with people that know where the best sites are. When you've only got a week as the first sort of recognition for what Iceland's like, you can't beat the local knowledge. Off to see the Northern Lights tonight, hopefully. It's a bit overcast at the moment, so whether that happened, I doubt it, but we'll wait for them to tell us where the best viewing sites are and times. There you go. Putting some air back in the tyres now. Need to deflate the tyres earlier on to get up the hills and the slopes with the snow. It's like real powdery stuff. It's like baking powder or sugar. But there you go. See you in a bit. Big monster wheels on these babies. Big Mercedes monster truck. Love it. This is really very faint. I hope you can just about pick this up. I'm talking really just about pick this up, but It's starting now. Place called Ingolsfjall, a glacial river. We've been travelling for about an hour, maybe a bit longer, had one stop already. But this is some of the most stunning scenery with the sun coming up. Again, the camera just doesn't do it justice at all. Incredible place. Mountain ranges in the background. Absolutely beautiful. A couple of big volcanoes in the background that apparently are ready to go. Stunning. is the Fax waterfall. They name it after the mane on the back of an Icelandic horse's neck. Fax waterfall. Again, what a stunning place. Alaskan aspen that they've started growing throughout Iceland, which will take a few generations to grow, but it's planned to cater for a lot of building requirements. It's Alaskan aspen. The other tree, or one of the other trees, native to Iceland, being the silver birch, grows more like a shrub than anything else because of the weather conditions. This has got to be one of the most spectacular waterfalls I've ever seen in my life. That is just immense. That is unbelievable. First step apparently is 11 meters high. The second step down into the canyon is 20 odd meters high. Wow.
I hear a child crying for shores and the forest knows, but it won't share the secret when the king takes a hide, leaving mortal minds. Soldiers take their share. Nighthawk seems to sense that now is the time. Deep inside them burns the raging fire of light. They'll take back what it owns. Death cannot take hold if I can keep momentum. Fortresses of stone turn into crystal tears.
So what you're looking at just here, this black wall running all the way along, is the North American tectonic plate that is the other side of this rift valley. We just walked over a big fissure. We've got another one here. Oh, it's just spectacular. The colours in the sky have just got like a pastely hue to them. Gorgeous mountains in the distance. You can just pick out on this camera the kind of pinky, bluey, pastely hues. Stunning, stunning place. And so yeah, this big wall at the top here, that's where the tectonic plates on the North American side is. So right here we're looking out into the void between two huge tectonic plates, with one massive, massive great fissure just down here. You just cannot appreciate the enormity of this view that we're looking at right now on camera. But I hope it sort of gives you some sort of idea of the kind of vistas that you're going to be looking at if you ever chose to visit the place. Absolutely stunning, and the light's fading as well. And you can imagine what this place would look like in the summer when it was you know, not necessarily covered in snow and everything else. Just stunning. Looks like we've got a steam upshot of steam over there. You can just see the plumes in the distance. Beautiful sunset. And it's cold. Thank you.